So George Green has just been sent off. Here's Asante. Oh no, he's hit the post.
Hello one and all, my name is Ria, welcome back to another Match Day Vlog. So tonight, Chester FC make the short journey to South Cheshire as we play away in Nantwich Town in the Cheshire Senior Cup quarter-final. So a bit of a background information on this game. So in the preliminary round we beat Witton Albion at home 2-1 before beating Winsford United away 4-0 in the first round. So we are now in the last eight, so if we do win tonight then we'll get a step closer to reaching our first final since 2013. So we'll be interested to see what sort of team we field tonight, because some of our supporters think we'll field a strong side, whilst I have a feeling we'll field some mixture of our first team and youth players as well, because that worked out really well in the last round. But some people want a reaction from our appalling defeat away at Kidderminster on Saturday, so let's see what happens tonight. So of course, hope you enjoyed the video today. Please leave a like and subscribe to my channel. Also feel free to comment down your thoughts on the game below. So let's get into today's video right now. So with this only being a Cheshire Cup game tonight, it won't take too long to get to Nantwich for me. It will only take about half an hour, so I'm looking forward to it, and it will be a bit of a nice short journey compared to recent weeks where we played the likes of Kidderminster Harriers and spending more time away. So it will be a nice short journey tonight. So if we do get beat, then it won't be a long journey home. So never been to Nantwich before, because this will be our first away meeting in a competitive fixture since 2011. So it was quite long ago now, and I didn't really go to away games back then, so you can understand that really. So it's not too far away, Nantwich. So Nantwich, you played the Weaver Stadium, and it's quite nice, to be honest. It holds 3,500, so it's not a bad ground considering what league they're in, because Nantwich, you only play one league below, so it's a decent ground, to be honest. So on one side you have the main stand, which is an all-seater affair. It's drawn to the halfway line, but still it is you have got some good facilities in there as well, so it's not a bad stand, to be honest. And opposite that is the ice cream fan stand, and it's a covered terrace, and again it flirts with the halfway line really. So again, it's a decent stand, to be honest. And behind both goals are flat standing terraces, so they are uncovered as well. So I think the weather will be quite cold tonight, so I might not go there tonight, but if I do, then it will be a bit cold tonight. So behind both goals are flat standing terraces, so all in all, it's not a bad ground, to be honest, considering Nantwich playing the Eastern Northern Premier League. So let's talk about Nantwich then, because they are doing really well this season. They are fourth on the table, so they are pushing for promotion to the National League, and also we could actually be playing against them next season in the league if they do get promoted. And of course, if we stay down, which hopefully won't happen, because we are falling a bit of late, so we better get an act together sooner rather than later before it does come too late for us. So wish Nantwich all the very best for the rest of the season in there. Quest for promotion to the National League North, but it is our job tonight to knock them out of the Cheshire Cup. So Nantwich, you have got a former Chester FC player amongst their ranks. His name is Will Jaaskelainen, and he is actually the son of Yussi, who is the Wrexham goalkeeper coach. But as you may know, he had a lengthy spell at Bolton Wanderers a couple of seasons ago. So Will Jaaskelainen, who plays Nantwich, and he was here last season on the loan spell from Crewe. He didn't really play too much too many times for us, but still he did have a bit of a loan spell here. So yeah, Yussi. He plays Nantwich as well, so will be a player to look out for tonight. And also, if you haven't watched my match day preview, we did mention about Ricardo Fuller, who used to play for Stoke City many years ago. He is 39 years old, but just a couple of weeks ago he actually signed for Nantwich. So that was a bit of a shock to many, because not many people thought that someone of his calibre would sign for Nantwich. But just a couple of weeks ago, Ricardo Fuller, who is a striker as well, he actually signed for Nantwich. So if he is to play tonight, then he'll be a player players to look out for as well. So Nantwich, I've got a couple of players to look out for tonight. So our most recent meeting with the Dabbers was back in 2016. It wasn't a pre-season friendly away from home with me, and we drew 1-1 away there. So hopefully we can go one better tonight, and hopefully we can get a big win, because as I say, the last time we won this competition was back in 2013. We beat Stalybridge South 6-2-1 at Witton Albion's ground. So it will be great if we can go all the way again this year. So really can't wait for the game now. Hopefully we can get a win tonight. Hopefully this will build some momentum for us. So my score prediction is Nantwich Town 1, Chester FC 3. So I do think we'll win tonight. I think it'll be a tough tough game now, you know, because Nantwich are just a couple of places below us really in the footballing pyramid, so they are doing really well this season, so I do think they'll be up for tonight's game, and I do think they'll name a bit of a strong squad, but just think we'll have a bit of enough firepower for them. So for Chester, I think Lloyd Marsh-Hughes, Nathan Brown and Matty Waters will score for us, and for Nantwich I think Ricardo Fuller will score for them. So I think it'll be a hard game for us tonight, but I do think we'll have enough to get over the line in the end. So of course, really can't wait for the game. Now it is a new ground for me as well, so you know, can't wait for, to get it ticked off my list as well. So really can't wait for the game now. So my vlog will be coming up right now. So of course, hope you've enjoyed the video today. Please leave a like and subscribe to my channel, and also feel free to comment down your thoughts on the game below. So come on, Chester, let's do this, and hopefully we can advance to the next round. Come on, lads. So I have just arrived at the Reaver Stadium, and looking around, it's actually quite a nice setup, to be honest. So yeah, really can't wait for the big game now. Hopefully we will be able to progress in the next round. So yes, come on you yellows, let's do this. Go on, Chester! Come on, yellows! Here is Nantwich Town squad for tonight's game. And here is your Chester FC squad for tonight's game. So we are in a 4-5-1 formation. So in goal is number 1, Connor King. In defence is 2, Bradley Jackson. 3, Matty Waters. 5, Danny Livesey. And 6, Steve Howson. Midfield is 4, Captain Scott Burton. 7, Dan Mooney. 8, Guy Roberts. 9, George Green. And 11, Craig Mahon. And up front is 10, Anthony Dudley. On the substitutes bench is 12, Akwasi Asante. 13, Grant Shenton. 14, Iwan Murray. 15, Matty Thomson. And 16, Lloyd Marsh-Hughes. So, enjoy the vlog. Come on, you yellows.
Okay. Okay, so we are 5 minutes in here. A bit of a cagey start so far. We have had a, you know, one half chance really. A bit of a cross floated in, but Nantwich managed to clear it away. But a bit of a scrappy game so far, but nothing to report you on just yet. Oh, come on, Dan. Cut it in. Oh, lucky. Dan Mooney there, just, you know, cut inside, but shot just went miles over really. But yeah, still 0-0 here. So an Nantwich player has just got a yellow card, really strong challenge on, I think it was Scott Burton from here, so yeah, an Nantwich player has just got a yellow card and it was a poor challenge really, so I suppose it's the right decision really, but you know, just got to be careful there, that Nantwich player, a bit of a precaution there, so 0-0 still, but you know, we are creating a few chances here, but hopefully we can get a goal very soon. So we are now 10 minutes into the game here at the Weaver Stadium. Nantwich, they just had a free kick, just headed wide, but they are showing a few signs here, so we must be aware of that, but still 0-0 here. In there has been a few you know, things to report on, so Nantwich, you have had two chances, just blazed over the bar really, in fact he actually went out of the ground, so Nantwich had a couple of chances and also we had the free kick, but Will Jaaskelainen and the Nantwich custodian, he saved it quite comfortably really, so it's getting a bit lively now, let's just see what happens now, but yeah, still 0-0 here. Oh, and in fact, Nantwich just had another chance there, actually. The opposite side, another chance, just gone wide. So they are coming into this game a bit more now. But yeah, 0-0 here. Let's just see what comes out of it. Now we are 20 minutes into this Cheshire Cup tie, and Nantwich has another chance just a couple of minutes ago, went wide, and also Ricardo Fuller, he had the shot blocked, so we are looking a bit ropey at the moment, Nantwich, sorry Chester, but to be honest, I think Nantwich, you are probably the better team, but still goalless, so you know, hopefully the next time we report we have gone 1-0 up, but we are looking a bit ropey here, so you know, just see what happens now. Gone, and Nantwich are still piling on the pressure, so they had a free kick blocked by, I think it was, I can't remember now, was it Matty Thomson? Then they had a corner, and you know, the initial header was, I don't know how he missed really, because it was from like 2 yards out, and he somehow missed it really. Then Scott Burton, you know, he blocked another shot by Nantwich, so they're starting to come into this now, you know, and we're looking a bit shaky, but there again, we had a bit of a spell on the right hand side a minute or so ago, but didn't really materialise anything, but 0-0 here still, so looking a bit shaky, so you know, hopefully we can get to half time maybe 0-0, then see what happens in the second half, but 0-0 here still. Come on. Oh, shoot! Oh, lucky. Brad Jackson there, you know, cross went in, and I think it was Anthony Dudley who had a shot wide, but we have a corner now, so come on, you yellows. So it's 25 minutes in now, still 0-0. Nantwich just had a shot offside, blazed over, but we're actually starting to come into it a little bit more now. As I said, we just had a corner, then Steve Howson's header went over, and before that, Brad Jackson had a decent spell out wide, but we're looking a bit better now, so 0-0 still, but we are looking a bit better, so hopefully, yeah, we can do something. So yeah, come on, you yellows, so let's hope. Oh, good ball, come on, Dan. Oh, he's just lost it there, Dan Mooney. Decent run again by Brad Jackson. He is looking good tonight, but Dan Mooney just couldn't find his feet really. Half an hour gone, we are still goalless. Anthony Dudley had a shot just before, but he was flagged for offside, but it didn't actually go in either, so still without a goal here, but we are looking a lot better now. Here is Scott Burton on the ball, but oh, he's in here, he's in. Let's square that. He's in. Ooh. Oh, lucky. Dudley had another shot, a bit of a scuffed effort really, Nantwich, a bit easy for their defender at the end of the day, but 0-0. We're looking a lot better now, so you know, let's see what happens now. Nantwich had just scored a disallowed goal. It was offside, but you know, where they actually scored a disallowed goal there, so he must be on our guard a little bit now. But thankfully, the linesman put his flag up. But 0-0 still, and thankfully, you know, we're still at it. So yeah, still 0-0 here. Now into this rather lively Cheshire Senior Cup encounter. As I said, Nantwich just had a goal chalked off through offside, and also just had the free kick but blazed over, really. So they are, you know, it's a bit of a decent game now, a bit end to end. So you know, nearly half time now, but still there without a goal. So George Green has just been sent off, so we're now down to 10 men. Well, I thought he won the ball, but I can see why the ref gave it. So yeah, George Green is off, and he got sent off the other week, remember, at FC United in Manchester as well. So two red cards in the space of a month, really. So not good disciplinary record for him, but we're down to 10 men now, so you know, that's a bit of an advantage for Nantwich. But whilst we're at it, still 0-0 here. But just be aware now, we are down to 10 men, so George Green has just been sent off. We are now approaching half time, so we're 40 minutes into this game, and as I said before, Jules Green has just been sent off in the past 2 minutes, so you know, major disadvantage for us. But nothing's really happened over the last 5 minutes, but yeah, we are down to 10 men now, so not good news for us. So the half-time score is Nantwich Town 0, Chester FC 0. So we are down to 10 men too, where George Green got sent off for us. So it was a bad challenge, to be honest now, because I was just speaking to a few of our supporters. So, you know, a bit of a bad challenge, really. So no complaints from me. But, you know, it's been a decent game, to be honest, for a Cheshire Cup tie. We've had a few chances, but to be fair, for Nantwich, they've probably been the better team. But no, still 0-0, but we have got a you know, numerical disadvantage, really. So let's just see if we can get a breakthrough in the second half. If not, then be straight to penalties. So it's now half time, 0-0. So enjoyed by Mike and Cal again for tonight's game. So start off with Cal this time. So do you want to say your thoughts on the game so far?
Yeah, I didn't really know what to expect today, to be honest. Obviously, Nantwich being a few leagues below us, I know they're doing pretty well in their league. Never knew what kind of team we were going to put out either, but after watching that first half, Nantwich deserved to be winning. There could have been more sendings off, to be fair. George Green probably deservedly went off, but they're probably going to make the extra man count second half, so it's going to be tough for Chester now, I think.
So do you think we'll be have enough to progress?
Hopefully. I think if they bring Asante on up top, and you know, we can keep their back four busy, hopefully the quality should shine through second half. But like I say, it's going to be ours, because one man extra.
Yeah, so Mike, what are your thoughts on the game so far?
Yeah, I'd have to agree with Carl, actually. Again, I didn't really know. I know Nantwich are doing quite well in the league at the moment. I know they're pushing to for promotion this year.
Yeah.
I agree with Carl. I think they've been probably the better side in the first half. George Green shouldn't have gone in for the tackle personally. I think the midfield looked a bit open at times. Hopefully we'll go through. But yeah, we just need to show a bit more passion, second balls, need to win them a bit more often. Yeah, hopefully we do enough to go through, so see what happens second half.
Okay, thank you. Oh, lucky. Craig Mahon just had a header there, a bit surprising considering how small Craig Mahon is, but just had the header there saved by Will Jaaskelainen. So we are now 5 minutes into the second half. Thought we're looking quite good, to be honest, considering we have a numerical disadvantage. But Brad Jackson, he's been really good tonight. He had another chance down the wing, you know, decent shot, but you know, just went over. But also Craig Mahon, he had a header as well, and as I said a couple of minutes ago, a bit surprising considering how small Craig Mahon is. But fair play, had a header at the back post. Could have done better, but you know, a bit of an easy save for Will Jaaskelainen. So still 0-0 here. We are looking quite good, to be honest, but you know, we're still early stages yet in the second half. Oh, There were 55 minutes into the game, still goalless. Nantwich have had a couple of chances. Stinging shot saved by Grant Shenton, well beaten out for a corner. Then Nantwich, just a couple of seconds ago, they had a free kick but went well over. So still without a goal here. We are coping, but you know, we are starting to die down a little bit now. So 60 minutes in, we are doing quite well now, to be honest. Grant Shenton made a couple of really good saves a few minutes ago now, and we are now off a corner. It's in. Oh, we've got another corner, I think. No goal kick, but you know, Craig Marnie had a shot as well, so we are doing quite well now, to be honest. So Grant Shenton made a couple of really good saves by, you know, from close range, and we actually now have another corner, so let's see what comes out of this corner now. But no, we are doing quite well in the second half, considering we have a bit of a disadvantage. Corners in, back post. Oh, sudden play. Shoot. Oh, unlucky. I think it was Gary Roberts, it was. Great shot, it was, on the edge of the area, but the Nantwich keeper, bit of an easy catch from, but doing alright now, so 60 minutes gone, still 0-0. So Ricardo Fuller has just gone off, ex-Stoke City player. It's all right tonight, to be honest. 39 years old. We are now 65 minutes in this decent cup tie, and again Grant Chance has just made another save to his right hand post. So Nantwich, you are probably the better team now. We are showing some signs, but for Nantwich, you are looking quite good. I think this advantage is starting to be in their favour a bit. But I think Brad Jackson tonight, he has done really well on the right hand side, and his return as well, I thought he's been really good as well. So nice to see him out on the pitch tonight. But Nantwich, they have had a few spells, so you know, 65 minutes in, still goalless. So a double substitution here. Craig Mahon has gone off, and Akwasi Asante has come on as well, and also I think Matty Thomson has come on too. So hopefully Asante will continue his fine goal scoring form. Oh, nearly. Asante nearly making an impact there, just couldn't get on the end of a cross by Dudley, but it was offside as well. But nearly made an immediate impact there, Akwasi Asante. 70 minutes gone, not much has really happened. Nantwich just had a cross come shot, don't know what it was, but it just went onto the roof of the net. But really, that's it really over the past 5 minutes. But yeah, we have got Akwasi Asante, he's just came on now, so hopefully he can make a bit of an impact for us. So we only have 50 minutes left now, so we are 75 minutes in, still goalless. And I tell you now, if it still stays like this, then it will go straight to penalties, I believe. So a bit of heart and mouth time here. And, oh, here's Brad Jackson on the right-hand side. What can he do? Oh, gave it away. But yeah, if it stays like this, then it will go straight to penalties. So I hope not, but if it, you know, if it's the best case scenario for us, then let's just take the gamble. Now here is Brad Jackson. Oh, that was out, wasn't it? Thought I was out for a corner then, but Akwasi Asante, good work by him in the middle of the play. You know, passed it out wide to Brad Jackson. He tried to do the best he could, but you know, a cross came in. Nantwich, you know, cleared it away, and it almost went out for a corner, but just took a throw from here, and it's out for a Nantwich throwing. So. Yeah, still about 10 minutes ago yet, but still goalless. So there you go, Brad Jackson is coming off. I thought he's done well tonight, and he's coming on this Lloyd Marsh-Hughes. So hopefully he can get some for us, Lloyd Marsh-Hughes. Been a decent physical player for us on this day. So Jackson's come off now. I thought he's been alright tonight on this return, but Lloyd Marsh-Hughes has just come on for us. Well, Matty, oh, unlucky. Matty Waters, it was. He had a decent dribble there. Passed it wide to Matty Thomson. Had a shot and it was deflected, so we now have a corner. Here we go. So the corner was just whipped in by Matty Waters, just by me, and it was didn't really reach anyone really, but nothing still came out of it now. Around 8 minutes to go, 0-0. So hanging on to dear life here, but as I said before, if we can get to penalty. Oh, here's Asante. Oh, no, he's hit the post. Oh, Akwasi Asante just hit the post. Oh, my God. If that went in, I'd be going mad. Oh, so close, though. Great ball there by Matty Thomson, though. But Asante, like, 8 yards out, hit the post, but just hit the post there. But as I say, take it to penalties, then I suppose better than nothing, just see how it goes. But, oh, God, could have gone 1-0 up then. So near. Now, for another corner, Matty Waters has just gone in, and here we go, all just wide again. So we are coming into this a bit more now, of course. Asante hit the post, and another shot just went wide there, so who knows, it could actually nick a late winner, really. But just had two chances there, so doing quite well, to be honest, considering we've had to play more than half of the game with 10 men. But not doing too badly here, and Nantwich just have a substitution, so just see what happens now. But we are coming into it a little bit. We are now approaching the dreaded full-time and the dreaded penalties, and it is looking very likely now. We only have about 4 minutes left in this game, so see what comes out of it. We had another chance there, and also Nantwich very close, just a couple of inches wide. It's Lloyd Marsh-Hughes here. Come on, Lloyd. Oh, nearly. Great save there by the Will Jaaskelainen, and hit his knees. But nearly there, but yeah, 4 minutes away now. From penalties, and if you can hold on, then that's not bad, to be honest, because Nantwich are a good team, and they're coming into it now. He's in, dragged wide, and crosses in, and Grant Shenton catches it. But yeah, 0-0 still. It's not awful, but hasn't been a bad game, to be honest. But as I say, just a couple of minutes away now from penalties, so getting myself ready for that one now. So we now have a free kick. Gary Roberts whips it in, goes to the back post, and just saved by Will Jaaskelainen. So another chance for us, but say about 3 minutes left now. Very likely now penalty, so just have to wait and see. Unbelievable football, isn't it? Nantwich have won it with the last touch of the game, basically. Oh, I'm gutted, I am, because we've held on well second half with 10 men, but Nantwich, they've won it virtually the last kick of the game, and couldn't really blame Grant Shenton. I know he saved the initial header, but couldn't really do anything about the follow-up. Oh, I'm gutted, I really am, to be honest. I know, really hard to take, really, but Nantwich 1-0 up, seconds to go. Bit surreal, really. Bit hard to take, but that's football, I suppose. Chester Cup and all, I know. There are bigger things to think of this season, but it's looking like we're out of the Chester Cup now at the quarter-final stage. So seconds to go now, bit gutted, but football, isn't it? So the Nantwich fans are going absolutely mad in their cup final. Finished Nantwich Town 1, Chester 0, last minute. Unbelievable, but I suppose we can focus on the league now. A bit gutted, because I would have liked us to go all the way, really, but gutted. But I thought Nantwich gave us a good game tonight, fair play to them. They took advantage of that one-man advantage, really. So fair play, they won, but a bit gutted. But I suppose, focus on the league now, hopefully get back in the playoffs, Boston Saturday.
she's gone, and I have to say,
Nantwich Town 1, Chester FC 0. So we've just got back from the game now, and I thought we didn't play awful tonight, but just a bit in a bit typical Chester fashion, really, just conceded in the last minute and just didn't really produce anything tonight. So I enjoy doing my vlog in a different way tonight. I've got a few things, you know. I was a bit nervy going into this because I didn't know how it would go, but I actually enjoyed it tonight. So you know, it's a bit different from recording. I'm still gutted I can't record the game, but at least I can still do my vlogs in you know, a bit of a productive manner. So enjoyed that tonight, but the actual match, I thought we were okay tonight, considering we had to play more than half of the game. In fact, you know, with 10 men tonight, because it wasn't, yeah, to be fair, it wasn't sending off all day long, really. George Green diving in and, you know, took the Nantwich player down, really. So straight red card all day, and that is actually a second red card in the space of in the space of a month now, really. So not good by him today. So thought he played okay in the first half. Thought it was a bit of a lively affair, to be honest. I thought Nantwich, they probably the better team, but I thought, I thought we had a few chances as well. I thought it was, I think it was Matty Thomson as well, who had a few chances, and also Craig Mahon had a header as well. So I thought in the first half we did okay, but you know, in the first stages of that, I thought we were a bit sloppy, to be honest. I thought the pitch was really good tonight, but I think it was a bit dry, to be honest. So that did affect our passing game tonight, but thought Nantwich were probably the better team in the first half. So was goalless at half time, but it still was a bit of a lively affair, you know, a few challenges in, you know, in and around the pitch tonight. So yeah, George Green got sent off just before half time, so you know, that provides us with a bit of a numerical disadvantage. So thought in the second half we were okay, to be honest. I thought when Akwasi Asante came on, he was really good. He hit the post as well, and I was close to celebrating that one going in as well, because it was great work by, I think it was Matty Thomson, who you know, set Akwasi Asante up to, but he just hit the post, really. And I thought Brad Jackson needed really well tonight on his return. He got subbed off in the second half, but he has been injured for the past couple of games as well. So it was nice to see him return tonight, and I thought he did really well for us as well. But I thought in the second half we did okay. Craig Mahon had a chance for, I think it was Dan Mooney hit, who had another chance as well. I think Steve Howson did as well. So I thought we had a few chances in the second half, but Nantwich, you know, they had a few chances as well. You know, Grant Chesney made a few good saves as well. So you know, minutes ago, you know, I think it was in the first minute of added time, so just 2 minutes ago, Nantwich scored the winner. Grant Chesney made a really good save on the initial header, but unfortunately just couldn't follow up, really. So 1-0 to Nantwich, and in the end I thought they were probably the better team this evening, but work to be done now for us. So we are out of the Cheshire Cup now. A bit disappointing, but I suppose we can focus on the league a bit more now. So we have got Boston United at home on Saturday, so that is a vital match for us. So hopefully we can get a win there, but it will be a tough ask as well. So hope you enjoyed my match day vlog tonight, and of course hope you enjoyed it. Please leave a like and subscribe to my channel. Also feel free to comment on your thoughts on the game below. So you know, I have tried a few new things out tonight, so I hope you enjoyed it, and also make sure to subscribe too. So we'll be going to the Boston game, so on Friday we'll upload a match day preview from the course on Saturday, and we'll do a vlog on that as well. So yeah, hope you enjoyed the video today. See you at the Boston game on Saturday.